like India, you know?
Sri Guru Charana Padma Deva
Oh, I'm तिष्ठन् भजे तदानुरागी जनानुगानु कालम नयेद अखिलाम इत्युपदेश. दिस इज द सम एंड सब्सटेंस एंड एसेंस ऑफ ऑल द टीचिंग्स ऑफ श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु एंड श्रील रूप गोस्वामी. फॉर व्हाट थिंग हाउ वी शुड कल्टिवेट अवर एक्टिविटीज फॉर द प्लेजर ऑफ and how we can advance. He has first told that we have not come only to be in the Kanishta Vikara or always. We should try to develop our Krishna consciousness. What we were doing for 25 years before, same thing now, same mood. We should not stop in the same. We have to develop our Krishna consciousness. For this he is telling. At first when we came and joined this Krishna consciousness, we are chanting Hari name. And even today we are chanting, but not same thing, like geometry first and for PhD, let ABC be a triangle, that first and the last in PhD classes, ABCD are not same thing. So, when we were chanting first, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And now after 20 years, same thing. Our chanting will be so much developed. Our mood will be developed. How we can develop? Srila Rupa Goswami is telling. He has told seven slokas. Now he is coming internally and he is saying Tannam Rupa. You should read the translation first then explain. Yep.
The essence of all advice is that one should utilize one's full time, 24 hours a day, in nicely chanting and remembering the Lord's divine name, transcendental form, qualities, and eternal pastimes.
Why? 24 hours, why? Why 24 hours? We'll have to do something for life maintaining. We'll have to take some sleep. We'll have to do for our families, our children. Why is that? How you can reconcile all these things? You'll have to reconcile. This is the difference between first chanting Hare Krishna and now this chanting. He will explain further in his purport that how we can do it is possible. But not the persons to whom it is very hard to chant 16 rounds. He told that I am giving some concession because Western devotees cannot do it. Always they are engaged in worldly things. For them, he is telling that 16 are not all, not for advanced devotees. For them, he is telling. What he is telling? 24 hours a day. Then, now senior devotees return. How it can? Then, oh, this is the idea of Narayan Maharaj. Not our Swamiji. He never told. For this I am telling all these things. Swamiji has told more than me, very strongly. One day you will have to come to this stage. Otherwise your love and affection for Krishna will not be so. For new fault, he had new five devotees, he had told that, oh, you should begin from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 6. Let him be advanced. He should give up all the worldly attachment. No worldly anything desire. Then he may can advance. Otherwise, how he can advance? So he is telling how to do. Then, first time, thereby?
Gradually engaging one's tongue and mind. In this way, one should reside in Braj.
Oh, then he is telling that you should give up all these places and come to Braj. How it is possible? How possible? How it will be possible? If you have no desire, nothing, then you will be pure devotee, then nothing to be here. Or anywhere, only to touch. But those who are not qualified to be in Braj, anyhow, they should live by mind also. This is conversation. But after some days you will have to go there in Braj and get them all these worldly Braj also, you will have to go where? Grow in the written in bracket, one should reside in Braj. Guru Vrindavan. For sadhak it is absurd to be below, to go in Guru Vrindavan. Understand this? A sadhak cannot go to Guru Vrindavan. After liberation, after praying, anyone can go there. But his object is to go there. So he has written in bracket that object is to go there. But in sadhana avastha, we will never be in Goloka Vrindavan. And we will tell that our Guru Maharaj has written like this Goloka Vrindavan in sadhana avastha. This is for sadhana avastha. This is shloka is for sadhana. Sadhana, you know?
Yeah.
In the stage of bondage. How he can be Goloka Vrindavan? So Swamiji has written false. No, you will have to
reconcile
all this. He has left something to reconcile. otherwise you commit. If you tell that, oh, he has written Golok Vrindavan, so we'll have to be Golok Vrindavan Dham in the stage of bondage. How it is possible? So we'll have to use our intelligence also. And that intelligence will come in the association of very, very qualified person. Otherwise, there will be always confusion. So many doubts will come to reconcile this. Anyone cannot reconcile all these things. Those who are not so developed and realized, then again, in this way, one should reside
in Braj, Goloka Vrindavan, and serve Krishna under the guidance of devotees.
What is the difference between devotee and associates? Can you tell Parshad, Parikar and devotee? Anyone?
A devotee is a sadhak. Yes. An associate is an eternal vijasila.
Eternal, he is liberated. Who? Associates that are called Parikar. They are not devotee. They are not sadhak. Whereas devotee is used, you should always consider it that he is like sadhak. How a sadhak can be in eternal dham, Golok Vrindavan? After liberation, after having prem, then Jogmaya will take him for eternal. Otherwise, no. Devotees cannot go there. When they will go? When they will attend Krishna praying. Sneha, Man, Pranay, Rag, Anurag, Desh. After that. Otherwise, no. Only serving cows, only distributing books, not going deeply in them, and doing all these activities, only making life members and all these things, it will make some impressions. That is Sukriti. It is for Sukriti. These are not actual pure devotion. But what he is telling, it is pure devotion here. You will have to come one day in this platform. And then we can attend Krishna thing. Otherwise, never. Lakhs and lakhs. First time, bus, we can. Then we are bound to do some offenses. He is telling that whole time, 24 hours we should do chant and remember. You should not follow him. I went once in my mutt in India, and I was expressing all these things. All became happy. But after that, mutt commander or superintendent, he called all the devotees and told them, Narayan Maharaj is telling you, don't follow him. You should serve cows. You should go there, and make bhiksha and do all these things. Chant only 16 minutes. Don't do more than that. And if you are following Narayan Maharaj, then you will be devastated from bhakti. You cannot live, you cannot maintain your life, and thus everything. All the boys came to me and told that, yes, then much superintendent telling you that. So one should follow?
One should follow in the footsteps of the Lord's beloved devotees who are deeply attached to his devotional service.
Now they are coming to Bhakti. He has told here, in translation very, very little. Now this.
Since the mind may be one's enemy or one's friend, one has to train the mind to become his friend. The Krishna consciousness.
Manaye manushyanam karanabandhan
mukhtai.
Manaye eva karan. Mind is cause of bondage and
liberation.
He is our enemy and he is our friend. So you should try to train mind at first. If your mind is not in friendly terms, he is enemy. And if you at that time follow mind, then you will go to hell. In state of bondage, we learn not to take shelter of mind and to take any advice from that mind. What to do? Follow Krishna, Raghunath Das Goswami, Guru Dev, all the disciples, acharyas. Not to follow mind, what mind is telling? Have a whip. And control mind by that whip daily 10 times. Take a broom, and get on the back of mind 10 times daily. Then you will meet. Otherwise, you know, the tails of dogs, like this, always. If you will take 100 pipas of ghee and rub it and make
straight.
Again, if you will give up, it will be. So mind it like this. So always weeping. Controlling. By taking the shelter of any realized Rasik Tattva Vyavaisna, maybe like this. Otherwise, no. So mind is like that. You'll have to be very careful. Oh, mind. If your mind has become your friend, then very easy to remember the pastimes of Krishna. So he is telling that Swami or Rupa Goswami, that first of all you will have trained, then all your bodily activity, senses, will follow this.
The Krishna consciousness movement is especially meant for training the mind to be always engaged in Krishna's business.
That is how Jiva Goswami established this. Krishna consciousness established by Jiva Goswami. Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha. And all our acharyas are member of this. Sometimes, Jiva Goswami was president. After that, Raghunath Das Goswami became president. After that, Krishna Das Raj Kaviraj was president. After that, Shyamananda Prabhu, Narottam Thakur, Srinivas Acharya. And after that, Vishwanath Chakravarti was very famous president of this Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha, that is Krishna consciousness. No? After that, after some time, Baladev became very powerful president. And after that, there came a very deep Andhakar
Yuga.
But after that, Bhakti is not very prominent, and Saptam Goswami became the president and he preached. And after that, he preached all over the world by his arms, like Swamiji, here, there. In very short time, his one hand preached over whole world. Swamiji was very greatest, one of the preachers and president of Krishna consciousness, especially that Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha. And he gave some new bottle, but same wine. New bottle. And the new bottle was the name of that Krishna consciousness. But for intelligent person, It is the same wine, but in yoga. Some are now deficient, and they don't want to accept this theory. But I think that they are not intelligent. Krishna movement is eternal, you should know. Not new anything. I think this Krishna consciousness is eternal. Its followers are also eternal. Third class bogus Kanishtha Adhikari is not member of this. Only they are doing something. But really, all the liberated souls are members of this Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So, if you will be like Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Prabhupada and Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, our Guru, then you will be member. Otherwise, like simple chowkidar, you know. Get this one. Like dog sitting on the gate, something. Actually, you will remember at that time of this Vishnu Vaishnava Sabha, alias Krishna consciousness. And that is Krishna consciousness as it is. Anyone has, the chokdar has no power to reject anyone. Never. Then?
The mind contains hundreds and thousands of impressions, not only of this life, but also of many, many lives of the past.
How? Anyone can explain how? Mind has what?
Hundreds and thousands of impressions.
How? Anyone? You? Who? You?
The mind contains impressions of past lives which are carried within that subtle body.
How thousand and thousands of impressions?
Yes.
How?
Because they come
in a moment. In a moment. Lacks and lacks impression and going on. What you are thinking? I will beat that person. He is a very wicked person. I am loving him. Some affections to anyone. Some opposite mood to anyone. Sometimes abusing anyone. All are becoming impression in your mind. And you will have to taste lakhs and lakhs, but only for a moment impressions. Understand this? Clearly or not?
Yes.
In your word, you can tell.
That all the impressions of previous experiences are stored in our mind like a tape recorder.
Also present, you are doing.
Yeah.
Or your age is like 60 or 50. But how many impressions you have kept in your mind? You know? Unlimited. Anyone cannot count. And you will have to test all these impressions in lakhs and lakh kotis birth. You have killed an ant when you are passing on a way. Will it come in like impression or not? Unwillingly or willingly, you are going apart. And so many chants, ants were there. And you kept unwillingly your foot there with shoes, very hard shoes. And among them, about 100 ants died. And you never cared, but impression will come. Willingly or willingly, you are doing. How? Your son is keeping his hand in fire unwillingly. He does not know that it is fire, it will burn. But if he keeps hand, fire will burn or not? If it is done unwillingly?
Certainly
burn.
If you are keeping some kerosene oil, you know kerosene oil?
Kerosene
oil. Here, 18. there will be some smell or not. Unwillingly it is kept, or willingly kept. It has some.
Bad smell.
So you are doing anything unwillingly, unwillingly. It will come liberation. A bull came and he wanted to take on his horns and he made some pain to your body. You took a very big stick and get him 3-4 danda. Will it be impression or not? Can you tell?
Certainly.
It will be. Bull will have no impression because he is in fruitable
active karma joni.
Karma joni, that is. Not active joni.
They are suffering their karma.
They are suffering. So he is suffering. If he will take you like this, it is your past time's impression. If you are silent, thinking that, oh, he has done for my past activities, I should be silent. Then okay. And if you are doing the danda again, then new impression. And that bull will become like a man and he will have to. If you are taking flesh of any cows, the cows will be men. And you will have to cow for so many births and he will take flesh again and again. So these are impressions of lakhs and lakhs times. And also for this also, we are making so many impressions. Don't try to make any bad impression. What impression? Always chant, remember Krishna. If anyone disturbing you, no harm, like Haridas Thakur. He was strong enough that he could have rejected, that he could not bite him in 22 markets. If he has prayed to Krishna or nothing, he was Brahma. He could have resisted. And he can, by course, he has destroyed that Muslims who are waiting. But he did not exercise the power. So, in this way. So, always chant and remember. Especially, he will tell, Swamiji is explaining that in our last days, at the time of death, what you will remember, chant, you will be liberated from this world. Otherwise, if your whole life you have chanted, but at the time of death, you are remembering any prostitute or any bad thing, then you will have to go there. Be very careful.
These impressions sometimes come in contact with one another and produce contradictory pictures.
What is the meaning?
Like a dream. In a dream, you may have an impression of a mountain may come, and another impression may come up of gold. Say you're dreaming of a gold mountain. And
in about this life?
This life and previous lives?
No. But he's taking
steps. I know why.
These impressions sometimes come in contact with one another and produce contradictory pictures. How? In this life.
What? They perform pious activities, impious or spiritual activities, and by nature they're contradictory and complicated.
Like example?
I might plant some trees, give some charity, but then I might do something sinful, and perhaps I might come into good association and do something spiritual. So my mind is not, this is not fixed. I'm involved in so many contradictory things.
You have so many pastimes you have done. You have done so many things, and bad activities and good activities. If they are coming in the same time in this life, you will be confused. And you will be in doubt that what should I do? You saw a very beautiful lady, or ladies saw a very beautiful male. And he was at first attracted, but he has any good wife, chaste wife. He's thinking, these two feelings are coming from past activities, impressions, and he is not deciding what to do. I should have attachment with this new lady and give up my old lady, my wife. What should I do? But this is so beautiful. My first wife is somewhat aged. So what should I do? But this lady is very young, very beautiful, very sweet. What to do? It becomes indirect. It may be that four, five, six, so many at a time impression will come. What to do? But what impression is so strong? It will defeat all these things. Wife tells that you should go to Krishna consciousness. Otherwise I will take poison and I will die. So you should select whether you should go in Krishna consciousness, chanting, remembering, doing. And wife is telling that you should take flesh, eggs, meat and be enjoy with me. And if you are not coming to me, and if you are going to be pure devotee, I will take at once poison and I will give poison to my old girls and what I should do. These are all impression due to past activities. They may come 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at a time. And at that time, it is very hard, big problem. Any devotee can shake it. So we should try to do. To go in his association, any root, realize so. He will solve it in a very, like this. Like Narada solved a hunter. Hunter was entering in a, hunter was there in a very big forest, and he has bow and arrow with poison. And he used to shoot one deer, and he was being chatpat-chatpat.
Half dead.
Only suffering. Running down. Aware, he saw Narada, he was going. He is half dead, and he also
suffering.
Suffering so much and doing chatpat-chatpat.
Restless.
Again he crossed that thing, he saw another, any deer or he saw some birds that they were also flapping like that. At last, he came nearer to that hunter. Hunter came with his bow and arrow and he told Narada, why you come in this way and you have disturbed me? By all shikars. Understanding? By all this to whom I am to and they are now going here and there, running here and you have disturbed me. I will kill you. People that you cannot kill. You have no power to kill him. You have no power to touch him. She towards you and he took some drops of his water from his paw and his pelican. He at once saw. Lakhs and lakhs these animals are ready to kill me. They are killing me, and again I am taking birth, and again they are. And they are in a row, lakhs and lakhs.
Waiting.
Waiting. He at once became frightened. And he was rolling down on the yard. Again he took some water and sprinkled. He became in knowledge.
What? He became in sense.
Sense. And he fell flat on the lotus feet of Narada. Save me, save me, save me. He told that they broke your arrows and
bows.
Then what will you take? How will you maintain life, my dear? Or don't care for it. In whose quantity all things will come. Only take some. But first you should.
Distribute your possessions.
And in a moment he changed. And he was changed. And he became very big saint. After some days, Parvati Rishi and Narada was returning from the same way. And he now becomes so poised, then he used to wash the way to do pranam to Narada Rishi, so that any one chant ant cannot be
smashed.
He becomes so poised. Parvat Maharaj told us, who is he? Oh, he is my disciple. He was a very big hunter. So listful. Well heard. Now he helped me. Oh, you are a stone.
Touch
the stone. In moment you can turn anyone. So if a person like him, devotee, will touch us, then our mind can be controlled. Otherwise, so go in Vrindavan. How much time?
12.
So, what is this slok?
Jangam
Yam Vapis Muravaham Jajat Kante Kuleva Tam Tamay Vaikikonteya Siddhartha Bhavavarata. Whatever state of being one remembers, when he quits his body, that state he will attain without fail. At the time of death, the mind and intelligence of a living entity create the subtle form of a certain type of body.
What word?
For the next life. If the mind suddenly thinks of something not very congenial, one has to take a corresponding birth in the next life. On the other hand, if one can think of Krishna at the time of death, he can be transferred to the spiritual world, Goloka Vrindavan.
Any example for both? For what?
Becoming a deer.
Yes. You are thinking of me. But if you will think of Krishna and Krishna associates, certainly you will be like that. Any instance? Example? Yes, Adam became like this. So many Shrutis has been like that. Shruti means Ved. Ved is not a book, not a only piece of paper. Srimad Bhagavat is not a piece of paper. Gita is not a piece of paper. But without that we cannot see, because we are blind. Mortal. But Srimad Bhagavat, Gita and all Vedas are mortal, immortal, like Krishna. So we cannot see that. His teachings are important. So we cannot realize all this. Only we can realize by cultivating all this. Of activities to please Krishna. And then it will come in the stage of bhav, then we can realize the little. So we should try to develop our Krishna consciousness, sadhana, like bhav. Go on.
This process of transmigration is very subtle.
So Ved, Shrutis, Mantra became Gopi. Dandakaranya, Rishis became Gopis because they were thinking like this at the time. From very beginning they were thinking, at last in the last stages of the day of the time of death, they thought like this and became. There are so many lacks and lacks. So if you are always thinking, remembering, like gopis, like Sridham Subal, you will be like that. Don't remember alone Krishna, then you will be annihilated in Brahma. Then it will go against. So we should remember Krishna with his associate, especially more bending towards associates. This is, try to realize this fact. We should chant, remember whom? Who are serving Krishna? More than Krishna. Like what? We will, if we want to love Krishna like mother and father, we will have to be like, to follow Nanda and Yashoda. And Krishna like his son. And if in the, at the time of death we are doing so, then we will be this servant of Nanda and Yashoda like mother and father, and we will serve Krishna. If you want to serve like gopis, then you will have to think like that. You will have to do like them, how to serve them. You will have to be expert in this life for all these things. And gradually thinking gopis with Krishna, how they are serving Krishna. And at the time of death, you are realizing.
Remembering.
Remembering this thing. You will be the servant of this. That's it. This is the hidden secret. Swami has not told all things, but he has told in
condensed form.
This is like sutra. Go on.
Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami advises devotees to train their minds in order that they will be
unable. You should note all these things in your heart if you want to advance. And if you are advancing only worldly desires, only thinking of that, you cannot go. You are not following Swamiji. You have to develop all these things in this way, gradually, giving them coming in this.
In order that they will be unable to remember anything other than Krishna. Similarly, the
this process of transmigration.
This process of transmigration is very subtle.
Now, subtle means here?
Sukshma.
You'll have to take this process. Don't always go on outwardly thinking and adopting artificial and all these things. Outward. Very going deep. Otherwise, you cannot understand all these things. Go on.
Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami advises devotees to train their minds in order that they will be unable to remember anything other than Krishna.
He is telling that you should remember half all these things and half that. What he is telling? If anyone is not doing like that and remembering half, more than half these worldly things, even a sannyasi can go down. He is bound to go down. And if being a grihastha, but gradually developing all these things, he will go up.
Similarly, the tongue should be trained to speak only of Krishna and to taste only Krishna Prasad. Srila Rupa Goswami
He is telling that even at that time you should do all the outwardly things, make a garden, make all these things. In first stage he has told, only to make some impression. But in these advanced stages, what he is telling? Swami is telling what I am telling. And what I am telling, he is telling same thing. No difference at all. But how they are discovering differences, I don't know. Same thing, in same bottle, not another new bottle, I have brought any new bottle. Same bottle, same wine, same thing. As our whole Dishatrik Acharya has
there. Srila Rupa Goswami further advises Tishtan Brajay. One should live in Vrindavan or any part of Vrajabhumi.
Why he is telling? To whom he is telling? To devotees or undevotees?
Devotees.
So that, why they are telling that Narayan Mahārāja is telling different things? I'm telling this, but not for all. Not qualified, they should be in Vraja. They have no requirement of all these attacks. Gradually they will be in Vrindavan. And at last, for always in Vrindavan. Swamiji is not telling this? Same thing?
Vrajabhumi, or the land of Vrindavan, is supposed to be 84 kroshas in area. One krosha equals 2 square miles. When one makes Vrindavan his residence, he should take shelter of an advanced devotee there.
Who will be there? If anyone is there. Always he will be there. And always he's searching his requirement, worldly requirements. And he wants to fulfill his desire. Very beautiful Raj Palace. All the facilities, like a king, they should not go there. They should not go there. Giving for all the desires. Only to serve, not to be served. Only to serve. Whom? A pure devotee there. Not seeking all these worldly things there. Not twirling. We are money with all. If there is attachment, very good, bad thing there. If you are doing some sins, it is like Vajradi. Like thunderbolt. Don't do all this. You should practice here all these things. And then reviving. Good.
In this way, one should always think of Krishna and his pastimes.
If a man has so much problems, oh, what to do, my wife has left me and he has gone to another. What to do, how, my children, how I will earn my
money,
what to do. Always thinking of this thing and he is in Vrindavan, quarreling at others and so much diplomatic and so much all these things having, so much policy. Rajniti, politics. Then how he is Vrindavan? He is not in Vrindavan. But he is doing some sinful activities. This is
further elucidated by Srila Rupa Goswami in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
I will explain it tomorrow. And it will very, very good thing. I wanted to finish this sloka. I will try to finish tomorrow. Anyhow, I will try to finish tomorrow or day after tomorrow. I have only one day life here. Today is 24, 25th, 26th, I will have to take rest. 27th in body, I will have to go. But actually, I will not go. I will be in this bridge near Govardhan, near Yamuna. I will try to come again if you will like. And then after this we can discuss more things.
gold, vima. Any kirtan?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, All glory to the assembled devotees. All glory to the assembled devotees. All glory to the assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauram.
Where is Krishna? Oh. Yesterday Krishna?
Krishna.
Oh, yeah. See.
He Krishna. Was Krishna. He was a good Krishna.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. That would be nice. To see. We're supposed to meet with all the devotees now.
Krishna, 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 Krish Yesterday I told about the reasons, the causes of Krishna coming. Why Krishna came? For bad things. He came in the jail of Kansa on the womb of the as a Vasudeva. And in the same night, same time, he came to the womb of Yashoda, from the womb of Yashoda. But it was so hidden. There are so many explanations that Yashoda Devi has given birth of Krishna. It has been told that Krishna always lives in Mathura, and also in the same time it has been written, Vrindavanam parityajya padamekam na gacchami. In any case, in any way, I cannot leave Vrindavan. For a moment, and in the also, we see that he always lives in Vrindavan. He also lives in Dwarka. Never lives in Dwarka. We have to reconcile. How? Yashodanandan, the Brijesh Nandan, always being in Vrindavan. So when Krishna was in Mathura, he came 400. It means that he was like Narayan. Having so much affluence. When Devakiya and Vasudeva prayed Krishna that you should be like a child, otherwise Kansa will come and he may kill you, thinking that, oh, he is Vishnu, has appeared. Krishna smiled and became a child. How he became? The boy who has taken birth from the womb of Yashoda, he came and took this 400 and both were mixed. Aishwarya Krishna mixed in Madhurya Krishna. But an argument may come that Vrindavan Krishna, he never left
the boundaries of Vrindavan.
Yes. Then it has been also stated like this, or Goswami has written. Then when Vasudev take 400 Krishna and he became child. Sometimes in Mathura and Dwarka, 400, sometimes in 200. So when he became like 200, Vasudev took him. And when he came in the midst of Jamuna, that is the border of Gokul, Vrindavan and Mathura, from there he Jamuna, he took his fate to Jamuna. Jamuna was flowing. And the water came like this to Vasudev, Krishna, and he took Krishna on his head, on a
basket.
Krishna took his fate from the basket, lowered down, and it was touched to Jamuna. Jamuna was subsided again. At that time, Vasudev Nandan, through Jamuna, he was there in Mathura. And that Gokul, Krishna, that is the son of Yashoda, from there he went with Vasudev ji in his basket. Vasudev Nandan cannot go cross there in towards Vrindavan. So anyone could not saw, but reality was this. From there he went to Gokul and he slept there and he took the baby and returned to. This is more applicable. Why? When Akru took Baldev and Ram from Nandgaon, Braja, he came to Jamuna, near Jamuna. In Jamuna, there was a Brahma Hrada, a part of Jamuna. And it was now evening. So he kept Krishna Balaram on the chariot. And he went to take bath and to do Anhi, Sandhya. So when he was taking bath, he drowned in the Jamuna Hrada. At once, they came there. Who? Devaki Nandan, Ram and Krishna from Mathura. There, in the midway of Jamuna. Because this is the borderline. And Yashoda Nandan Krishna and Rohini Nandan Ram, always living in Vrindavan, they returned from there. They disappeared. Akru could not think that how it became. He saw that Krishna Baldev is here. And he was saying that he is there also. How it became? He could not reconcile anything. He began to pray like this. And in the middle, everything was done. Krishna and Baldev, Rohini Nandan and Krishna Yashoda Nandan returned from there. And Krishna and Baldev of Devaki Vasudev, they returned to Mathura. No? So it is more applicable. Understand my view? This is the view of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. So, always, eternally, Krishna is the son of Nanda and Yashoda, and eternally son of Vasudev and Devaki. But partly and fully. Where fully? In Gokul. And partly because Narayan is the vaibhav of Krishna. Understand? His vaibhav.
Expansion with a slight change.
Yes, slight change. So, he is also Krishna. So, our Goswamis has reconciled his heart like this. In a Vrindavan, any demon cannot enter. But how Putana can? How Putana can? He sees the demon. There are two Vrindavan. One Golok Vrindavan and other is Bhaum Vrindavan. Also, Gokul are same. There also Gokul, also here Gokul. But this Gokul in Vrindavan where we are seeing now, it is called Bhaum Gokul, Bhaum Vrindavan, Bhaum Praja. Bhaum Mathura. Bhaum means? Related to earth. And that is called Golok Vrindavan. Both are same. But sometimes when Krishna disappears, we cannot see Krishna and his pastimes in Vrindavan, not so beautiful as at the time of Krishna. Here demons can come by the order of Yogamaya. Anyone, general person can see Krishna, no harm. But in Golok Vrindavan, only liberated persons having so much praying, Sneha-man, Pranay, and they can go there eternally. Otherwise they can go there. Here there are some difference. Sometimes Krishna comes, sometimes Krishna is not seen here. But they are always always see, always felt. There is so not so much separation. Only for 4 months or 3 months we can see that he has gone to Mathura and Dwarka. But actually, not. And here, we see that Krishna went to Mathura and Dwarka. Forever he never returned. Only we see. And we calculate by any examples that Krishna came after the death of Dantavakra. And he took in all Brajavasi who went to Golok Vrindavan. So, any demon cannot come. Where? In Golok Vrindavan. But in this Prakat Vrindavan, Prakat means Bhaum Vrindavan, Bhaum Gokul, by the arrangement of Yogamaya, why? To renew the love and affection of all Prajavasi. In Nitya Navin.
Nitya Navin means renew. Ever fresh.
New. If Krishna is son of Yashoda, no harm. But then he will always in the lap of Yashoda, taking the milk, and Yashoda is also loving him. Then she may neglect Krishna. Sometimes he will rebuke and tell, that's it. I don't want to take. I am busy in my house affairs. So you should go and play. But when Putana will come and take Krishna and give poison, and she will become so much 6 miles.
12 miles.
His body became like a mountain hill, like this. So big, big eyes. This is tall. His hands, 3-4 miles long. These hands. And it became very ferocious. When Krishna was saved, I will never give up my boy. Then he used to always, always. 4 days, 5 days. After that, again Trunavarta comes. Again Shaktasura comes. And renews all this. New affection to Krishna. Krishna don't want to test any old thing. And he becomes always new one. So these are going on by the help of Mogamaya Krishna done all these things. When Yashoda and Rani were there in the courtyard and Krishna was sleeping on the jhulpalna. Then Putna at once came. Why she came? It was very dangerous for him. His sons, his brothers were Bakasur and Nagasur. And she has the power of 10,000 elephants. Once can submit to him and began to fight with her, but she was so strong, he could not defeat. At last she told that, goodbye my sister, I'm making you my dharma sister.
Religious sister.
Religious sister. So, you should help me. I want your help. So she became friend of Kamsa. And when Kansa saw that Putana is qualified to kill Krishna, anyhow he had smell that the son of Nand is son of Vasudeva. And so he told his dear sister, can you help me? Oh, why not? In a moment I will go there and I will finish everything. He became glad and he went there. Very beautiful city. Some beautiful streets. Shape he made that all were moved. She also could sing very well. Very sweet. She went there. Like demigoddess. And he told that, oh, Yashoda, what you are doing? You are giving this child on the bed and you are sitting there. Perhaps you are not mother of and mother. And he took at once Krishna. At once Krishna closed his eyes. Why? He knew this fact. Oh, this is a demon. She has come to kill me. So he has come in the shape of mother and telling that this boy is my son. You are not my his mother. I am mother. Oh, he has come. As a mother, Yashoda and Rohini was cheated. They saw her beauty, artificial beauty, and they were moved. They saw that. Certainly we are not mother. Mother is she. Said, so they could not be worried, and she took in him Krishna and gave his breast to the mouth of Krishna. But no milk, very dangerous poison was there. She pumped like this, taking this poor mouth. Krishna took that poison and it became like nectar. And he also sucked life of Putana. And at that time she became restless. Oh, shed me, she remembered Kamsa. She was powerful, like 10,000 elephants, mad elephants. And she tried, oh, give up, and he tried so much. But as he was crying, and Krishna was talking more. So began to say. At once he forget his yogvidya. Yogvidya, you know? By which he has become in this sweet form. And she at once began. 12 miles, he said, became very dangerous. and if live in this sky. Oh, dear brother, send me, send me. Krishna told that, I never give up you. Anyone come to me, I never... If you have given your breast to me and I'm taking milk, why you are so worried? Don't cry. I will not let you go out of Braja. And so, telling this, he was only having his hands here, feet there. He could not get rid of Krishna. And she was soft. And then she died. Anyone comes to Krishna? Krishna never gets them. Next is anyone. So he made his mother. He was very kind to this. Only for that she has taken the shape of mother. Imitation. For imitation, if anyone do the bhajan of Krishna, no harm. After something, he will give, Krishna will arrange for his association of good works. And by that, he will have pure conception of bhakti. And thus, he will be liberated from this world. So, by touch anything, bhayat kansa, you know kansa? He has so much fear for Krishna, he was related by fear. Shishupal, Dantabhakra, all were like demons. But anyhow they had touched with Krishna, they were liberated. And those who will come with kam, you know?
Lust.
Why they will not be liberated? So gopya kama. With calm. And if pure love, like gopis, then what? Krishna will be controlled and controlled. So anyhow we have any link with Krishna. Or it may be artificial, no harm. A police CID. Understand police CID?
Criminal Investigation Department.
It's very first CIA.
CIA.
Same thing.
He was searching a culprit. He heard that that culprit was in Haridwar. He went there. And to make arrest, he has the shape of sadhu. Anyhow, he brought artificial. This jata, you know, and he took like door coping and so big mala, so big altar, and ram. So many classes of person coming, especially women of Punjab and other provinces, giving so much wealth, money. And so much dulces, fruits, vegetables, all kinds of sweet preparations. He is contacting all these scams automatically. Now he is thinking, I am artificial father. But everything Krishna has arranged to give me, if I will be really sadhu, then what will be? He gave up his all these beers and everything and really he became sadhu. No? He went in the association of sadhu, he took bath in Ganges and he became sadhu. So he telling that putana he gave as a mother patri in Golok Vrindavan. And he used to serve Krishna. In that day, Nand Baba has gone to Mathura to pay his taxes. At first, he did not care. He never went to Kans. But now, he has a very beautiful baby, like Krishna. Now he went himself to pay taxes to Kans, to satisfy Kans that she should not disturb anything. So he himself went. Before he was like a renowned person, no attachment with houses or anyone, but now he is attached to me. How to feed Krishna? How to support Krishna? How to love Krishna? And there should be huge quantity of milk and all other things. All this. He went to pay tax. And Vasudev told, Vasudev met there, oh, friend, my brother, they were like brothers, not like brother, but brother, a step brother. So he told brother, you should not live today here. At once you should return to Gokul. I think that in your old age you have a son, and my son is also there. He hides something. So you should go. Otherwise, danger may come. At once he paid tax to consign. In the way he saw, oh, very big mountain is there. What is this mountain? And it was never there
before.
And some were cutting her in pieces and also giving in fire. And from fire, so good fragment was coming. What is this? And goes, those were there. This is story. And he became so nervous. He ran to his home, telling that my brother Vasudev is foreteller. He is an astrologer, perhaps. What he has told, it is true. After that, I have told the story of Putana, who she was. Shaktasur was there. Who is Putana? Putana. Divide the word Putana. Put means pavitra, pure. Na means no, not pure. What is that? Always taking eggs, meat, drinking wine, blood and everything. If our devil doing all those silly things, we cannot have Krishna. We cannot go towards bhakti. These impure things should be given out. But you cannot do. I have seen so many Indians that they smoke bidi, you know, very little. Not so great, but younger brother of I told them that you should give up your smoking and then take harina. He never became ready. How I can do But if doctor will tell that you have cancer and if you will take cigarette and bidi, then you will die. Then he will have to. So Vaishnava tell them to be pure. If you are not pure, bhakti cannot come. So you should be pure. Someone tells in India, here I don't know. Pyaaj, you know, lashan?
Onion, garlic.
Onion, you know? Mm-hmm. Onion is a fruit. Why? So dangerous, nothing. Like pepe.
Papaya.
Papaya. Like mango, It is a fruit. It is like potato. Hot. So hot, hot. Oh, so hot. Dangerous. There are 21 kinds of poison in that. The doctors of America have infested this thing. So, Vaishnavas from early of the Srishti,
creation,
they have discovered all things, what is good, what is bad, what is pure, what is impure. They have discovered. So we should follow this. He killed Shaktasur. Huh? You know Shaktasur? What is the history of Shaktasur? Anyone can tell? Who will tell? Shaktasur? You know? Shaktasur? You can tell?
He was a ghost demon. And a ghost can either take an unmanifested form or a manifested form. And he...
No. He was friend of Kans. Kans told that I sent my sister there. But she never returned. What began? One thing I want to tell you here. That if Yogamaya don't want and he not helps, any demon cannot go there. Kans himself in his early time, once he went to Gokul to take a walk there. When he went there, he, after death of Putana, himself wanted to kill Krishna. So one day he went there. When he crossed Jamuna and began to enter in Gokul, at once a very old lady came and told that, "Who are you? Where you are going?" I am Maharaj Kamsa, Maharaj Dhiraj Kamsa. Emperor of emperors, I am going to Gokul to walk. She took the end of Kans. He was so strong and he dragged in the kunta. And he became an old lady. There were no teeth.
Fair hair.
And she could not walk. And he gave one kick to her. Kick that old lady. "You should be here." And always took some cow dung and gave cow dung here. All the inhabitants, Gop and Gopi, used to come and give one kick to her. "Oh, you don't know how to make cow dung?" He was so early comes. He wanted to come to Mathura, but he cannot come because anyone cannot believe that he comes. So he was also shaming that I am comes. He cannot tell to anyone. So for so many days, and he was weeping, crying, and all gopis are coming and kicking him. After that, Yogamaya again came and he fell on the lotus feet of Yogamaya and crying bitterly, save me. He told that again we will come. "No, I am taking my ears and never I will come myself." Then he took him and again found in the
Samkund
and now he became confined. Running. Don't see towards Gokul and Brajan. So he went. So he was always staring and that is why he never came to Brajan. Always sending another. He told to his friend that, "Oh Shaktasur, you are so strong. You can kill Krishna. But you know, Putana went there with shape. Don't go with any shape. Like air you should go. And anyhow, Krishna should not see you. Otherwise they will kill you. So because you should...
Invisible.
Without shape you should go as a air. He went there. And he entered in the same court under which Krishna was playing on a string. And so many little boys, naked, only of 1-2 years were there. And they were playing with Krishna there. Krishna was only a child of 30 days, perhaps. At that time, Yashoda was engaged in anything at the time of birth of Krishna, birthday.
Janma
Natchatra. The birth Natchatra of that. What Natchatra?
Rahini
Natchatra. Rahini Natchatra was there. What is the meaning of Natchatra?
Constellation.
So she was so much busy. So Krishna began to cry, but Yashoda was not hearing, so much crowded there. And noise was so much, all were singing, all the gopis were singing, all were assembled there. So big crowd was there. No one was caring for Krishna. Krishna alone, with some boys, was crying there. At once, that demon came, shapeless as air, and entered in the cart. Cart began to go down, down. He wanted to smash Krishna. So, Krishna was playing and weeping also. He was only above 30 days. He was doing his face and
kicking
like this. And at once it was touched by the feet of Lord Krishna. And it goes so hard and broken into pieces. All the parts of butter, makkhan and everything were upset here and there. The cord, biggest big cord, and it was also smashed into pieces. There was a very big sound there. At once Yashoda Nanda Baba saw that from where the sound is coming. At once they went there and saw that cord had been upset and broken. But boy was weeping. Kya, kya, kya. Like a child. And hearing this and weeping. Yashoda took at once that boy. Nanda Baba came. All the assembled there. Pati Saktasur. Saktasur like a cord. In India it is used to bring anything heavy from here to there, loading. What is loading here? To know all the Shastra, Sanskrit, Anuswar, Visarga, knowing. Going to inner cities, gaining inner city, impersonal or any gyan there. Is like bhar of the cord. Bhar, you know?
Weight.
So there are two things, bharvahi and sargrahi. Bharvahi and sargrahi. First is bharvahi. Knowing all these epics, Puran, Ramabharata, Ramayana, all these things, especially Mahabharata, everything. But always entangled with this body. Knowing everything, like Hiranyakashipu, he knew everything. He can quote anything, but not actually following anything. They are called Bharavahi. Vahi means to
carry.
So Saptasu is like that. He knows all the Shastra. He can shape, change his shape. He can be anything. But knowing all the Shastra, those who don't have any bhakti for Krishna, no taste for chanting, always giving instructions to others, not following himself, they are bhara, vahi, carrying all these things. Bad things always. And rejected things. And sarograhi, those who are taking essence of everything. How? Valmiki Ramayana has 1 lakh shlok. No? Once demons, human beings,
demigods,
and demigods were quarreling themselves. That we will take Ramayana, we will take Ramayana. At once Shankar came and told that I am dividing you, don't quarrel. Yes, you should divide equal. He was dividing. Three divided. Then 33,000 and 33,000 a slok he gets divided among them. Then 1,000, again he divided it to 3. 333. 333. And 3. It became 999. Even one slope was there. He divided into 4, 3. There are 4 divisions of each slope. So one part he given, but even one part was there. One part consists of 8 letters. So, among 8 letters, he divided 2, 2, 2. Again, remain what? That is Krishna or Ram. Ram or Krishna. He told that I will never give this to anyone. And he kept in his heart. So, Visar and Sam and Saptans, the essence of whole Ved Upanishad, is what?
Krishna.
So those who are taking Krishna, chanting, remembering this Krishna name, that it is the essence of all learnings. No? So those who are chanting Hari name, they have done everything. They have read Vedas, they have read Upanishad, they have read Srimad Bhagavata, they have done everything in their past. But so they have some best in name. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also telling that this is some answer. So those who are chanting Harinam, they are Saragrahi. Understand? Saragrahi means what is the sum and substance of the Ved, Upanishad and all things is Krishna name, Krishna Bhakti. So those who are doing, they may be chandal.
Low cost.
Out of cost, they may be like Jagai Madhai, they may be like what, Raman Kumbhakaran, or very lusty lawyer, even rotten person, but if they are taking them, they have taken the sum and substance, essence of the whole thing. So they are called Saragrahi. Grahi means those who are taking, and they are for farming all these, cultivating, bhakti, Krishna. So, Krishna kills this Bharvahi. And he shapes always. So we should be like Pasharagrahi. Then? Then one Kirtan should be like.
Namami Nandana, Namami Nandana, Namami Nandana, Namami Nandana, Namami Nandana.
was sitting in the lap of Yashoda. At once he became so heavy. So that Krishna and he seated Krishna there on the ground. At once a heavy straw, very strong, and everything was covered with
dust.
And it became so
dark
there. Even anything in hand was not seen. All was
eyes
closed because everything was going in. Dust was going in eyes. This was Daman, friend of Kamsa. He has come to kill Krishna. So he made this. And Krishna, he went just so that kept this boy there. He came at once in hidden way and he took Krishna. Krishna, catch hold of this ear, like hanging on his
neck.
He wanted to throw me, walk in air. At once Jogmaya made this and this demon came. And easily he took. Krishna was moving in the sky here. He wanted to throw Krishna and to smash. Krishna took his dish. Very easily his eyes came out like a Rasagulla. And he was doing like this, save me, but there was none to save. He tried so hard to get rid of Krishna, but he could not. He fell on the ground on a very big stone and he was smashed. But Krishna was playing there. No injury, nothing. Who was he? He is Trinavarta. What is the meaning of Trinavarta? Those who know all the Shastra, everything, Upanishad, Vedanta, and by this impersonalist knowledge, they cover bhakti. They make so many arguments like Shankaracharya, you are himself Brahma. No use of doing aradhana of Brahma. All the jivas are Brahma. All the things in this world is himself Brahma. Everything is Brahma. Sarvam khalvidam
Brahma.
What is the use of worshipping Krishna? No use. Why worship? You are himself Krishna. Krishna is shapeless, qualityless, anythingless. He has no attribute, he has no power, he has no qualities, even he is not merciful, nothing he is. And you are the same Brahma. They will quote lakhs and lakhs praman, evidence from here and there. How? Half from this, half from that, and make devil one. If Krishna is telling that I am Brahma, but you cannot tell Brahma. So Krishna is that place, he is telling that I am Brahmashmi. How you can tell that? I am Brahmashmi? You cannot tell. You are always lamenting, dying, suffering. How a man can be Brahma? Once upon a time, a Brahmavadi came to our mutt, Keshavji Gaudiya mutt, he was so much. I wanted that this person should go, but he was not going discussing. He wanted that he should adopt my thing. At once I told that, you are Brahma? Yes, I am Brahma. I told a Brahmachari, bring a
fire stick
burning
with flame.
Some more.
Stick.
So flame should go away so much. And I told that to give it in the mouth of because Krishna took fire. I will see that. And that fire was so big. And but I mean very little. So I told that four brahmacharis should catch hold. But I could not run away from here. And I will see this Brahma. That how in from and give this fire in his mouth. you are trying so much to fly, run. I told her, never I will give you. Let you go from here. I will see that you are Brahma. Actually, he brought some fire and I told that all should very tightly. Oh. And keep fire. Then you are like this. Never come to this place in your life. So, those who have the idea like this that Aham Brahmasmi, all are Brahma. This is Sakatam. Prinavart. Giving so much explanation, quoting all the sast and telling that we are Brahma, we are Brahma. So he is Prinavarta. Shankaracharya is like this. And his followers, especially Shankaracharya himself, Shankar, his very greatest devotee, Vaishnavananda Jatasam. But all his followers are like Prinavarta. We cannot kill, but Krishna can kill in a moment having this. He Krishna told that I will simply catch hold because you are taking me in the sky and I caught hold. And if your Rasagulla eyes are coming, what should I do? I was only playing with you. But after that, sweet pastimes of Krishna. Krishna has become now 2 years. Her mother, Jashoda and Rani, cannot take Krishna always in house, area, sometimes naked, 2 boys, moving on this. And they are going out of doors sometimes. And seeing anyone, they watch like, look like this, and if that person sing towards them, at once running, moving to his mother and coming, laughing, smiling. As they are seeing any strange happening. Sometimes, when they become more, they used to go out of. Sometimes, bulls were there, very big horns. We have seen the big bulls of Vrindavan, of very, very big. If they are sitting, without fear, they went to them, both Krishna and Baldev, and began to place with horns, riding on him, here, there, doing. And then Yashoda Maiya saw, oh, what you are there. He called Nanda Baba came, and anyhow he went. Once, Krishna and Baldev were playing. There were so many thorns, you know, thorns, heap of thorns. And any creeper of belly, chameli, jui.
Go inside to these thorns.
Thorns. Very beautiful flowers were there. But covered with thorns. Anyhow, Krishna. Anyhow, by tree or anything, he entered in that thorns. And when he entered, the thorns came down, and there was no
way out.
To come out. He took these flowers, but now he was weeping. Mother. I think Yashoda saw that his boy is
trapped.
And there is no way. He began to chastise Krishna. I will not take you. Why you did so? But Krishna was telling mother and weeping, tears were coming. anyhow she took that and took Krishna in his seat. Sometimes playing with weapons, sword and everything. Sometimes with serpents, snakes, they are giving their hands in the cause of bulls and anything.
Dogs,
but big dogs, playing with them. So dangerous. Once, Yashoda Ma told that, bring a cup, very beautiful cup, today is your birthday. Krishna went and he catch hold of any friend cup. Cup was so beautiful, very strong. Krishna catch hold of his neck and wanted to draw. But there is a nature of them that if you pull him, they will go down.
Otherwise,
opposite. And if you do like this, they will come opposite. So Krishna was taking that cup to her mother and he was not coming like this. Anyhow, he brought to his nearer to his home. And Krishna saw that a butter pot was hanging there. He forget everything and water came from his mouth. And he very greedily he was saying, how to take it? But cup was in his hand. At once he stopped the cup and wanted to ride to keep his fish there. When he did that and he caught hold of the pot, at once the cough ran and he was hanging. Yashoda came with angry. What you did? Why you are thief? I will never get down from that. You should hang proper. mother, and tears were coming. He was not imitating. And some gopis also, they were clapping. And Krishna became weeping. Then, you should not do further. Be careful for future. Otherwise, I will not take you. So Yashoda is testing. Sometimes, you know, that a fruit seller, any low cost of lady can, and telling anyone can take fruit, mango, orange, plantains,
pineapple, and all.
In India, it is system, I don't know here. So door to door, she was going and shouting like that. He heard and heard that. That is a very beautiful boy of Yashoda and Nanda. So beautiful, rare. She wanted to see that boy. But when he used to go to Nanda Bhavan, Krishna at that time sleeping, or when he has gone in there. With his father taking him. She came repeatedly, twice, thrice, four times, but she could not show Krishna. At last one day, Krishna was playing in the lap of Yashoda. And this Haldi cranny,
fruit seller,
taking his basket full of fruits, she was calling. Anyone can take fruit, and she at last forget this fruit. Govinda Damodar Madhav Govinda Damodar Madhav Eti
Govinda Damodar Madhav Eti
Govinda
Damodar Madhav Eti Govinda Damodar
cannot have a darshan of that boy. But today I will have take darshan. So he forget everything. She kept his basket there in front of Nanda Bhaman, in front of him. And she began to cry. Govinda Dama
Dama Dameji Govinda Dama Dama Dameji.
Krishna was playing in the lap of Yasoda. At once he heard this. He cannot stay there. Where there is Sankirtan, he must go there. Where Krishna lives? Naham Pasami Vaikunthe
Yoginam
Hrde Nacha Mad Bhakta Jatra Gayande Tatra Tishtha Minarada. I don't live in Vaikuntha. Never in the heart of anybody. Where there is going Sankirtan, so sweet. I live there. Where the sadhus, Vaishnavas are doing kirtan. I think Krishna must anyhow, in any shape is here. And here he is hearing all the kirtans and all things here. His pastimes, and he becomes so happy. So he could not remain there. He went from Yashoda lap and went and took some corns, wheat in his hand. Very little.
Palms
like this. And he did like so. He took so much, but everything. Only some were there here. No? And he was thinking that I am taking so much. He went there. Out of door he saw a fruit seller, any woman was there. She was lavish. She was of low caste. He went nearer and told that, oh, take these corns. He was quite naked. Only golden chain was there. Very beautiful looking. If Krishna has taken any ornaments and very, very good. But if he has not taken anything, he has some dots of ink or anything, any dust, all more beautiful he will lie. So he was naked, had some golden chain. Nothing, only his, this was tightened here. And some more punk was there. So looking beautiful, he went to that. Oh, give me fruits and take this. There was nothing, only two or four wheat grains. And he told like this. She was watching, looking. So beautiful Krishna. He never has seen any beauty before this. She saw up, down to mouth. And he was so much upset. She told, if you want to take, you want to take fruits? Yes, yes. I want that. You should tell me mother. And then I will give you. Otherwise not. This Krishna looked here. If not any is that here, mother and you will have to tell me mother and to be in my lap, then I will give you. Otherwise not. Krishna looked here and then he was saying that, oh, none is here. Only this lady is here. So he tell very
softly.
Mother and at once sat on the lap of that lady. And at once he came out. Oh, give me. She gave so much. But by only one, two fruits, one
Krishna could carry.
Banana or only mango, one, two, three, and it was full. Then he took like this and he took some of them. Now he is very gladly, smiling, laughing, he is returning to his mother. He gets all these things in the well of her mother. And her mother began to distribute to all. There were hundreds of gopis there. She distributed and it never came to end. Was never finished. what it was, this distribution, more coming. What became of that fruit seller after that? Krishna went and he took his heart. Krishna never returned it. Without mind, see, and heart, see, was there for so many times, 1 hour, like a mad person. And after that, anyhow, she took his basket here. And she was returned. When he came, she came to the bank of Yamuna, he saw that so heavy this basket is than before. He took off his basket and saw that it was full of jewels. So many jewels. She wondered how they came. At once she took all the jewels with his basket, her basket, and fell in the channel. And Govinda Damo
Dharamadaveti, Govinda Damo Dharamadaveti.
She had no heart, no mind, nothing. Where she went, she went. Anyone could not see. Where she went? Anyone could not see. His husband and all searching her. But Krishna managed to send him her Golok Vrinda. So never anyone can sense. So we'll have to be like fruit seller if you want to be like Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
Govinda Namo.
Tandulancha Sankhanda Yanto Musalai Pramukha Gayanti Gopya Januta Anuraga Govinda
Dharamadaveti.
Govind, all the gopis were clearing wheat and rice by musal, you know, in
mortar.
They don't talk anything. What they do? With so much love and affection. Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
They are cleaning house by they are doing like, but what they are telling? Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti.
Sons kept in frame. Swing? And bring legs thup thup. Oh, you should sleep. Not telling this, what they are doing. Like this doing, but Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
Govinda
Namo.
But what they are doing? Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
With all actions, they are serving their husbands. But what they are telling?
Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
They are chanting. Dadi means? How beautiful gopis! And taking the ropes in. Govinda
Namo Dharamadaveti. Govinda Namo Dharamadaveti.
In the morning, their boys are weeping and they're getting their breasts in the mouth of their We are householder. How to do in houses our? How to
practice?
No. How to deal with our members and doing all these things? Because we are householders, we are married with wives and children. Oh, from that for them, I'm telling all. Go do what? You do anything. But like Govinda. Remembering the past times of Krishna, there are some parrots in the cage. I'm telling to that parrot, oh, you should tell like this, Govinda. It's a fruit of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam to be like gopis and goats.